want you to imagine a world without breast cancer. That is our goal.
When my mom was diagnosed, it was like the floor fell out from under us. It was completely unexpected. She looked fine. I had no idea that she was even going to the doctor to have a lump looked at.
My name is Leslie Reese. I am a patient of Dr. Fetting's at Johns Hopkins, and celebrating my 10th anniversary of my diagnosis of breast cancer. And I'm thinking back upon all of the things I've been through over the past 10 years and my family's been through, and thinking about where science has come in that time period. And I'm both very excited by the science and sad about our inability to be able to raise enough money for really exciting research that we have planned at Johns Hopkins.
When Leslie and Tom asked how we should use the money that they and others were going to donate, prevention came immediately to mind. While we've made progress, there are still way too many women who die of this disease, and for women who are diagnosed and treated, they face uncertainty going forward about how things are going to play out.
The fear associated with in women who think they will get breast cancer is so high and cannot be underestimated.
Since my mom's diagnosis, we've since found that both my mom and my sister and I are all carriers of the breast cancer gene. Prevention is so necessary. I don't want to lose my hair, I don't want to lose my breasts, and I don't want to go through chemo. And I don't want anybody else to have to watch their loved ones go through the same thing, just like I had to watch my mom go through it.
What is novel about what we're doing at Hopkins is actually trying to define an individual person's risk of breast cancer. And this involves sampling their tissue, sampling their blood, and looking for minute changes in single cells. We are able to extract incredible amounts of information from their DNA that can tell us about their inherent risk, that can tell us about what they've been exposed to, and can hopefully tell us about their subsequent risk of developing breast cancer. We would like to devise technology that can accurately assess a woman's breast cancer risk every 5 years. So we can identify those at high risk and promptly reduce their risk. We can also identify those at low risk and minimize scans and treatment that can cause its own toxicity.
A second area of research for us is identification or development of compounds that could be used for prevention. We're taking a look at hanokiol and curcumin, two natural products. This is going to require a considerable amount of work to identify natural products that might have anti-cancer properties, or to actually develop drugs from scratch that can have these effects. But this is a big effort, and it's going to take a lot of support, and it's going to take a lot of time from dedicated researchers. Our team is ready to go. They're working on it now.
Why this is such an exciting time is that we have the tools, we have the expertise, we have the experience of working together, and all we now need is funding. One of the biggest problems with prevention, studying prevention, has been that notoriously it has not been well funded at a government level because the studies are complex, they take a long time to achieve the ultimate goal, and that is reducing breast cancer risk. Hence, philanthropic funding is critical if we're ever going to prevent breast cancer in our lifetime.
1 in 8 women in our country will get breast cancer in their lifetime. The way we deal with that risk now is we screen everybody we diagnose breast cancer when it's large enough to be felt or to be seen on a mammogram. But we need to do a much better job and much earlier of identifying who that one woman is.
If you said, well, we're not using, we're waiting until we all have smallpox and then we're going to treat people with smallpox, we'd all have smallpox. So why would we do that? Well, they came up with something to prevent people getting smallpox.
Now that my husband and I are expecting our first child, this research is even more important for me because I'm expecting the next generation.
We just must change the paradigm. It's not that cure is not important, it is, but it can't be the only iron we have in the fire. We have to think of other ways of trying to reduce breast cancer mortality. And prevention is the way that I think we can move forward.
And they're researching these things now, so it's happening. But what we need is to expand what's happening and be able to make it possible to help more people and to make more important advances in science.